telling you, I felt so bad afterwards. I had drank so much milk that, like, it was coming out not just my nose, my ears. It was actually leaking out of...
Oh! We're talking about Tron today, I guess.
Whee!
Hey, guys and gals, I'm here with a video. Today it is on the Diamond Select Wave 1 of Tron, which might be a Walgreens exclusive. Not totally sure how that works, because... The Flynn himself, there's going to be, and I think there's nothing on the back of this, there's a Flynn with blue striping and there's a Flynn with red striping. The red striping is going to be out at comic shops with Tron and Sark. The Flynn with blue striping is a Walgreens exclusive, but you can also get Tron and Sark there. Now, they come in I think it's like $17 each, which honestly is not bad, but the only accessory you get is a base and their discs. The regular release... which I don't know their full retail price. I know you can find them on Entertainment Earth for $25 each or $75 for the set. I'm not sure if that's a markup just because it's an online shop kind of thing or what, because those are coming with more accessories. I don't know what kind of accessories. All it says is effect parts, accessories, and you can build a recognizer with it. It's not going to be too scale with the figures, but that's what it looks like as far as I know. So go out to Walgreens, at least get your blue Flynn. Get that one. You want that one. That one's the one that looks the best, in my opinion. But there's the packaging. Looks great. If you want to read that stuff, you can. I don't. I honestly haven't even looked at it. So there's, yeah. The figures from this wave are obviously Flynn. And it's blue. I think it looks bad with the blue. The red, I think they're calling Infiltrator Flynn from when he was kind of trying to blend in. Some would say he was infiltrating. There we got Sark, and here we have Tron himself. Now, these figures are 7.5 inches tall, so if you have them next to like a Black Series or other 6-inch figures, they don't look really good with them. I've never liked that Diamond Select goes for this kind of larger scale. I'm assuming there's a kind of a legal thing where they produce figures in this scale, and then Hasbro and whoever can't complain because theirs are smaller. I don't follow that stuff. The stands they get are these little generic ones. They kind of work okay. The peg holes in the figure's feet, they're kind of big. They don't really grip as well as they should. I have tried using the NECA stands, which I like. The pegs in these are taller, but they still don't grip as well as they should. I recommend either putting a layer of glue, of nail polish, maybe gluing a little tiny bit of heat shrink on there just to thicken that peg up, and then they should fit in the figure's feet with no problem. But as far as the accessories, they all come with their ID discs, and you can store them on their back. Oh, Sark, you're going to have issues. This is why we should have started you off on your base. I knew you were gonna cause issues. I knew it. I could tell just by looking at you. You are the bad guy. Oh, there we go. Flynn, I shouldn't have problems with. Maybe it's my table. Maybe my table's just uneven. But there's those. Yeah, Tron, I have issues staying with. Tron is the hardest one for me to get posed. But you see, they all fit. They all have their discs. You can store them all on their back. You can take them off. And I'm gonna lay these guys down because the camera goes crazy when I don't. Flynn and Tron's discs are identical. Sark's disc is obviously painted differently, but there's how those look right there. Now, these are not just repackages of this Tron and Sark from the Kingdom Hearts wave, which I really thought they were. These are completely new sculpts. The faces might be the same, but the Kingdom Hearts release of Tron didn't have an ab crunch, had different leg joints. And they were modeled a lot more simply, as if they were from the game. These have a lot more fabric details, how they appeared in the movie. So if you had the previous releases, you can still get these, and you're getting an entirely new figure. The ones from that wave also had discs that couldn't be removed. But there is a problem. You have the discs. I'm glad they included them. But you can't have the figures hold them, at least how I would like them to hold it. I feel like they should hold it, you know, like this. The only way you can really get them to hold it well, if you kind of flex the disc, you can kind of get the thumb cupped around it, but gravity pulls it out. If you put it in the other way, you can kind of wedge it in there. And while it doesn't look great, it is possible. However, I've yet to really get them in a good pose as if they're about to throw their discs or they're using it to defend themselves. You can kind of replicate the Tron poster if you kind of balance the discs on their thumb or get some kind of way to support the discs. I'm glad they're there, but they're not really great if you can't use them with the figures themselves. So ultimately, I just leave them pegged onto the backs, and you can see all the detailing on Tron. The paint detailing on these is really, really nice. Tron looks good. You know, on the front, there is some very minimal kind of, I guess, overpaint, spillage, whatever, there. You got a little bit there. Sark, he doesn't have a lot. There's somewhat on his forehead of his helmet. And you can see the really nice sculpt of David Warner. I think it looks good. There's not really much problems with his paint. I think he has the best paint job out of the figures that I have. If you go to, I keep saying Clue. If you go to Flynn, I think that is definitely a younger Jeff Bridges. Looks really good. This kind of tunic is a rubbery material, so it does move with his arms. It does limit articulation a little bit in some ways, but it's not horrible. His disc, you can actually tuck underneath it, which I do like. So overall, the paint detailing is very, very nicely done. I am slightly concerned. These are $17 at Walgreens. There are future releases coming out that are $25. Those figures are going to have more accessories. I don't know what accessories. I kind of have an inkling that there's going to be replaceable hands. And I think Tron's the easiest one to do this. Because their little forearm guards rotate and can actually come off. Because the hands are just pegged in. And if you take that off, that's what he looks like underneath it. We don't want to see Tron naked if that's what he's looking like. That's just... Sorry, Bruce Boxleitner, but no, that's not going to work at all. It does click in. So I have an inkling that there's going to be alternate hands, which I would love a set of fists for these guys. I would like a set of hands that maybe had a disc sculpted in it, just for posing. But I don't know. They haven't shut them off yet. But when it comes to articulation, these guys have a fair bit. However, I wish they would tweak their sculpting a bit. And this is a problem that I've had with Star Wars figures, with NECA. When they sculpt their figures, they put in all this really good detailing on the biceps and the torsos, but you can't get the arms down by the sides naturally. And that's something that I really would love to be able to do. You have to kind of compensate where you just have their arms kind of angled inwards. And while it doesn't look great, it's really the best that I can do because I'm a notoriously bad figure poser. But articulation, they got all the same. Flynn's is limited slightly by his tunic. Sark's head is limited slightly by his helmet. But I'm going to go with Tron because he is just the basic figure. Head movement, we got what I think is a ball joint. We got some decent movement all the way around, which there's a good look at the likeness of Bruce Boxleitner, which isn't horrible. Shoulders, you got full rotation. They can start at the sides nice and far. I like that his little rubbery armor bits can fit over his shoulders and they don't limit anything. You have a bicep rotation, you have a double hinged elbow, which if those do stick, you can actually twist the arm and pull off the mushroom peg, and that'll give you a little more leeway to work with the elbow to get it loose. Sark had an elbow that with like the paint had made it very stiff, but get all these figures, play with them, get all the joints worked loose. A lot of them are going to have to be cracked, which isn't a bad thing. You get nice tight joints afterwards. So double hinged elbow. The wrist can rotate because it is a peg and it has a hinge so you can bend it inwards. They do have a slight ab crunch. You have a rotation at the ab there. It's slight forward and back movement. Sark actually have a lot more movement with his. So I'm not sure if I just haven't really unlocked Tron's enough. Flynn, he's got it. But again, it's kind of limited by the tunic, but you can see he does still wiggle. There's your Jeff Bridges head sculpt. I think his head sculpt is by far the best. And you can see the parts are not reused. Even their helmets are different. So that's nice. That's good. You go down. He does have the ab crunch. You go down to the waist. It does move as well, which his is still extremely tight. The legs can go forward. They can go back only so far due to how they're sculpted. They can start the sides a little bit. You have a thigh rotation, a double hinge knee, which feels like it might be on a ratchet. Their ankles are on ratchets, and I'm kind of conflicted on how I feel about that. The ratchets are going to be good to keep them posed and hold that pose, but it limits how much you can move the ankle. Because you see it goes from one click there, the next click is there. And Trons are very, very tough. And it makes it where... Ooh, there we go. Getting him standing is a challenge because the best kind of neutral position for his feet has him leaning backwards. And you have to kind of try to force it forward. Well, there goes that. You have to kind of force it forward and try to get little careful with it. But you can see he's still leaning backwards. And that's with his knees straight. I can get him there. a little better. So you can get him to stand. I feel like Flynn being a human, he would. I played him as this is him confused. He just came to the grid. He just looks like he's just kind of wandering around, and that works for me. Flynn, I have no problem posing. Sark, I have some issues. I wish you could have his head angled up more. Due to the way the helmet looks, it looks like it's meant to go up quite a bit more, but it doesn't hold that pose. And actually, if you do that, it makes it very, very loose. So he's always stuck kind of looking down, which wouldn't be bad if it was like, you know, the giant version. But this is regular old Sark, so I wish he could look more straight ahead. But posing-wise, I don't have a lot of issues with him. I wish there were some kind of fists so I could do some with him. I leave him very, very stationary just because Sark just didn't seem, you know, he just doesn't like anybody. That's it. Go ahead and take that disc, pop it back in there. And that, I think, is ultimately it for this video. I do hope this line continues. I hope it sells well enough that we can get more figures. I would love a clue. I would love if they would, at some point, go to Tron Legacy so we can get a proper figure line from that movie and replace what Spinmasters tried to do. If you are a Tron fan, I say pick these up. If you want the accessories, wait until the comic stores have them or pre-order yours from Big Bad Toys or Entertainment Earth. I do have a link to Entertainment Earth's listing for them in the video description. You want to check those out. If you want these now, check out your Walgreens and at least get your Blue Flynn. You gotta get the Blue Flynn. The Blue Flynn is the best Flynn. The Red Flynn's not a bad Flynn, but the Blue Flynn is the best Flynn. And that was tricky to say because my mouth is broken. But anywho, guys and gals, I hope you have enjoyed this video somewhat. I thank you for sticking around. If you did like this video, you can click some of my previous ones over there. You can even subscribe to the channel right up there. And if you do, be sure to hit that little bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. If you really like this video, there is a Patreon that I have. You can pledge and get some behind the scenes look and maybe upcoming videos, that whole little fun thing. If you don't want to, I totally understand. It's no problem at all. But I will see you around. Take care.